everybody. Tangible God is tuning in with you today. Blessings to all my kings and queens. Grand rising all day, every day. What does the universe want to tell us today? Thank you guys for tuning in. If this is your first time tuning in, don't forget to like, vibe, and subscribe with your girl, Tangible Goddess. Boop. Go ahead and hit that like button right now. And also, this always happens when I start my videos. It'd be silence of the lamb, and then I start my video, notifications, everything's going off. So might be some distractions today. I love you guys. I don't know what I was saying, but thank you. I do want to welcome my new subscribers. I got a lot of new subscribers lately, and I thank you guys so much. I really, really appreciate you for your support. I'm just looking at the wind blowing in here. The energy is a little heavy today, guys. Do you know what today is? It's twin flame Tuesday. The guy of your dreams really do exist. The girl of your dreams, she exists. She's real. This twin flame journey, guys, it can be a lot. I don't know. Are you going to end up with your twin flame? Are you going to end up with a soulmate? Are you strong enough to live your life as you please? Are you loving yourself enough to know that you deserve the best? Let's see. What does the universe want to tell us today? But guys, let's start off. The health tip of today is honey. Nectar. That sweet, sweet, sweet nectar. Honey. Man, honey has so many benefits. I'm just going to go over a few. It's an antioxidant. It lowers your blood sugar, improves cholesterol levels. It helps with insomnia, coughs, colds, headaches, fatigue, acne, eczema. I can't say that word right, but you know what I mean. Your skin, ringworm, ugh. But it helps with it, okay? It has zinc in it, copper, B6, good vitamins, iron, calcium, and magnesium. Magnesium is some beautiful, powerful stuff, guys. I take magnesium every day, pretty much, unless I forget. It has a very, very zen calming effect. Magnesium. Please believe me. Okay, guys. Whew. Quick message from your divine masculine to the divine feminine, from my spirit guides. Your divine masculine loves you with all his heart. That's a true statement. With all of his heart. Okay? Alright. My little crystal ball light is going out a little bit. I'm going to go ahead, guys, and light incense, set the mood. I just burned some sage. I burned some ancestor money. I hope you guys are taking care of yourself, meditating daily. Yes, getting in the ample amount of rest and sleep. Doing whatever it is to make you your best version. Love yourself, guys, above all. You won't be good to no one if you don't love yourself. No one. Not even those people you love. You may think, you know, as long as I'm loving them, I'm good. But you gotta love yourself, guys. Well, very, very important. Very, very important. Very important. Okay, love yourself with all your heart. Just like your divine masculine loves you. Okay, guys, let's get this reading popping. Whew. And when I mean the energy is heavy, I'm going to go ahead and hit my singing bowl just to clear the air. Loosen up this anxiety in the room, in the world. Yes. I love you guys so much. Thanks for tuning in. Let's see. I look alright. I got my alieness look going on today. No lash, lash off. Lash off. Okay. Let's see, guys. I got my light sheer tarot deck. We're going to start with Headspace of the Divine Masculine. What is going on with the Divine Masculine today, guys? That card popped up. I'm going to shuffle just a little bit more. I'm burning my beautiful, beautiful incense. It smells amazing. What did I get? I just grabbed a new pack. It's called Moon. Yeah, Moon. This stuff smells amazing. The Moon. Beautiful, beautiful incense. Spirit guides, angels, and ancestors, help us do this beautiful reading. Help me to spread this beautiful message from the Divine Masculine to the Divine Feminine, from the Divine Feminine to the Divine Masculine. Universe, soul. Thank you guys for tuning in. I don't mean to take all day. Be patient with me. Like I said, the energy is heavy. I'm trying to control my emotions. Energy is very heavy today. Message for the Divine Masculine. Message for the Divine Feminine. This is going to be from the universe. Message from the universe to the Divine Masculine. We just pulled message from the universe to the Divine Feminine right there. We're going to pull two cards for message to the Divine Masculine, from the Divine Feminine. We're going to pull one from. I got some new cards, guys, so bear with me. I believe I should be able to get through this tricky, smoothly, with the help of my spirit guides. Okay. To the Divine Masculine, from the Divine Feminine. To the Divine Feminine, from the Divine Masculine. I'm just letting the spirit guide me. I didn't know what cards I'm going to use. These are my romance oracle decks. Sexual magic tarot deck. This is the new one, guys, so bear with me. But we're going to get another message to the Divine Masculine from the Divine Feminine. That card popped over. Message to the Divine Feminine from the Divine Masculine. What do you want to tell your divine? I'll fix that later. I got my cards all shuffled up. Thank you guys for your patience. I'm just trying to get this good. Whoosh energy. La, 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 la. Don't think I'm crazy. I'm crazy, but I'm not crazy. Okay, guys. Let's see. Alright. I'm gonna pull one more card and that's gonna be it. Message from the universe to both the Divine Masculine and Divine Feminine. Ooh, I'm gonna pull this card. I'm gonna take a pause, guys. I feel like I gotta get myself together. One last card from the universe to both the Divine Masculine and Divine Feminine. Okay. And give me just a second, guys. I'm like, hey, guys, I'm back. Sorry about that. Let's get this reading popping. I love you guys. Thanks for tuning in. Okay. Message from the universe to the Divine Masculine is Eight of Pentacles. So this can be the headspace of the Divine Masculine. Let's see, guys. It can be the headspace where he needs to move his energy towards. Let's find out. Eight of Pentacles. It says there's a light side and a dark side. The light side is mastering a skill, an expert craftsman, the Merkur, and you put into your work, methodical progress, patience, determination, and soul purpose. The shadow side is seeking shortcuts to your determined, burning out, or giving up, or inexperience. Patience and determination are the best ways to ensure your success, Divine Masculine. Mastering a skill takes time and perseverance, and shortcuts are not the best path toward your... Shortcuts are not the best path forward as you build your experience. Remain dedicated to excellence and to developing your unique form. Study, practice, improve, and thrive. Your love, your soul, and your energetic essence, is put it into work and bring it into a consistent methodological way. Perfect your craft. Imbue joy into repetitive things that you find yourself doing. Find flow in the details no matter what it is that you find yourself dedicated to. If you know it's time to move on to something more inspiring, find your plan and do so. Consistent action is called for, and often we feel blocked right before we expand into new levels. It's okay to be imperfect as you learn. As you become a master, find joy in self-improvement to help you get there. With loving determination and perseverance, I become the person I long to be. That's beautiful, Divine Masculine. So your focus now should be perseverance and taking your time and follow your path, not letting anyone push you, but being strong enough to know your path and pursue that path. That is your message from the universe. Don't let no one deter you from your path, from you loving yourself and making yourself a better person. That's such a beautiful message for you, Divine Masculine. I love it. Eight of Pentacles, determination and perseverance. Look at that. Even though it's a female in there, take it as it resonates, guys. Your Divine Masculine can be telling you to stay on your path and persevere. It's just beautiful. Okay, guys. The message from the universe to the Divine Feminine, we're going to crisscross today, is Queen of Swords. Look at her. Queen of Swords. Message to Divine Feminine. You gotta be strong. She don't look like nobody can deter her. She looks strong. And she got a sword. So, Divine Feminine. And don't look at that bird in the sky. It's got a message for you. Birds are messengers. When you really examine the card, you see so much. You see so much. Let's see, guys. Queen of Swords, message to you, Divine Feminine. Beautiful, beautiful queen. Thank you guys for tuning in. Queen of Swords. Okay, the positive side is a thought leader, unbiased decision making, an excellent communicator, wise, logical counselor, integrity and honesty, being perceptive, perceptive, intelligence, being direct, seeking truth. That's you, Divine Feminine. I'm gonna read the dark side, but some of you Divine Feminines may be on this dark side, but the majority of you are in that light side. The dark side is sharp and sometimes cold communication. Thrive to use your words wisely and refrain from being mean or emotional, indifferent. A message to use your head more and your heart less. Aloofness and bitterness. So you could be that tough Queen of Swords where you just like, you ain't trying to use your heart. You just like cutting people left and right. You know what I'm saying? You can be a little bit tough. So Queen of Swords, that's the energy for our Divine Feminines. You could be either or. You could be a thoughtful leader, unbiased in your decision making, being very honest and direct in how you feel and seeking the truth in different situations, which is beautiful. Okay, it says, highly astute, intellectual, and honest. She watches calmly over her kingdom. Graceful and logical, her wisdom is framed in truth and proof. She avoids gossip or fluff that comes that others may want to hear. Yes, that's a true Divine Feminine. That all that fluff and you ain't trying to hear that. You looking for the truth, facts, okay? It says she asks you to be honest in your relationship, direct in your speech and witty. If you want to be not above all, wait a minute, what I missed? Okay. And witty, if you want to be not above all, to bring your clear-headed, unbiased reasoning to the table. Sometimes this communication style can come across as cold or cutting. So if you are having trouble communicating something that is difficult for another person to hear, know that you can always dip your toe into the cup of empathy and compassion to help with your delivery. Sharp analysis and careful consideration are always intelligent moves, as being able to clearly connect with others in a way that is easily accepted and understood. A clear heart, a clear mind will allow you to speak your truth always. Divine Feminine says, I speak with wisdom and clarity. Yes, Divine Feminine, make sure along your twin flame journey that you are honest, but have empathy. So you don't want to be so harsh that you cut people, you know. Sometimes people gotta get cut enough. Just be very tactful in what you say, but make sure that you are speaking your truth. Even if your voice shakes, like I'm doing now. Even though my voice shaking, but I want to be clear and I want to speak my truth. Get your truth across. Sometimes people will think they know how you feel, think they know what you mean to say, and just assume and run with it. Make sure that you are clear and decisive on how you feel, Divine Feminine, because you have beautiful feelings that are worth hearing. Don't let no one dim down what you have to say or run over what you have to say. Speak in authority. Queen of Swords. That's why some people gotta get cut. Some people gotta get cut. And it's okay, as long as you're in your truth, show some empathy and be honest. Divine Feminine. Okay, message from the Divine Feminine to the Divine Masculine is, we got two messages. We got getting to know each other. As you reveal your innermost selves to each other, you bond your deepness. So just be open with your Divine Masculine if you're in contact with him, with your soulmate, whoever you're in contact with. Divine Masculine, this is from your Divine Feminine. Get to know each other. So I'm tripping. I think I kind of read that wrong. Get to know each other as you reveal your innermost selves to each other. Your bond deepens. This is for the Divine Masculine from the Divine Feminine. So she's telling the Divine Masculine, let's get to know each other. Deepen the bond and reveal your innermost selves with each other. Bond your deepness. Bond your deepness with your special person. Divine Masculine. Take it as it resonates, my sweet loves, kings and queens. When I tell you this energy is buck wild today, it's buck wild. So please I hope that you guys get a message today. It's everywhere. The message is wild. It's like fire. It's like air. It's like the fire's blowing the air. It's tornadoes, everything. Take it as it resonates. It's all over the place. Second message from the Divine Feminine to the Divine Masculine is the Hierophant. The Hierophant is someone that is just like the Divine Feminine, authority, high ranking. Some people related to Taurus, the Hierophant card. Look at this king. Oh my God. In this picture, is message from, I gotta remember what my message is from the Divine Feminine to the Divine Masculine. Man, looks like he's in a tough situation. Look at that Divine Masculine. You see that, guys? It's a guy. Let's see if my focus. Focus! It's a man and two women. We got to keep it real, guys. In most situations, the Divine Masculine is two women. It's his karmic, soulmate, what have you. And then you got the Divine Feminine. Hierophant. What do you do, Divine Masculine? Now, I'm all focused because I focused on that card. What do you do, Divine Masculine? What do you do? Both women don't look happy. He don't really look happy, but check. He got his hand on one of the ladies' head. Look at that. That's a Divine Feminine. Come on. That's a Divine Feminine. Here, he's caressing her head. This is either a karmic or a soulmate. They're both beautiful. They're both beautiful women. But two things can't occupy the same space. His heart is with one. He may be love, lust, but your heart belongs to one person. Your soul belongs to that one person. And that's the Divine Feminine at the end of the day. Hierophant. It's time to stand up and be a king and choose. You can't live like this forever, Divine Masculine. You cannot. That's what the Divine Feminine is telling you. Okay, message to the Divine Feminine from the Divine Masculine. I don't want to run out of time. Last time I did such a long video, it cut me off and I couldn't load it all. I had a half a video. So I'm going to bump, bump, bump. Let's get this popping, guys. The Divine Masculine wants to say to the Divine Feminine is keep an open mind. It says your soulmate may differ from your usual type and expectations. Your Divine Masculine is telling you, Divine Feminine, to keep an open mind about your soulmate. It says your soulmate may differ from your usual type and expectations. Your Divine Masculine want you to move forward with your soulmate. Oddly enough, but that's the kind of stuff that happened in twin flame situation. And he's telling you to keep an open mind about him. Go with the flow. Your soulmate may differ from your usual type and expectations, but keep an open mind. Message from your Divine Masculine. That's why he loves you with all his heart, because he just want to see you happy, Divine Feminine. Even if he's not the one that makes you happy. Communication is the key. Communication. Okay, and the last message to the Divine Feminine, from the Divine Masculine, is the Sun. See what I mean? It's all over the place. The Sun. Now, the Sun represents, like, everything, abundance, ultimate, everything. The Sun. The Sun. Take this as it resonates, my dear loves. The Sun. That's fire. That's fixated fire. Shout out to Uncle Fernando, who taught me so much about fixated fire. Love you. Let me take a drink because Uncle Fernando always makes me thirsty. Black seed and green tea. Healthy. Take care of yourself, guys. But yes, the sun. Look at that. Romance. That's fire. Your divine masculine wants you to get that fire. Take it as it resonates. This is wild. Okay, guys. Last message to both twin flames, divine masculine, divine feminine, from the universe is embrace your sensitivity. Embrace it. Embrace your sensitivity. Look at the dear little dear eyes and beautiful roses. Embrace your sensitivity. This is for both the divine masculine and the divine feminine from the universe. It says your sensitivity is your sensitivity is a sacred gateway to your intuition. That special receptive radar that picks up energy and signals. In fact, your sensitivity is one of your greatest assets and the key to your survival. The more you can connect with it, the more miracles and synchronicities you'll attract. Beautiful, beautiful message. So be sensitive. Be in your emotions. Don't try to hide them. Be true and authentic to your feelings, whether it's in your mind, whether it's in your heart. You have to be authentic and true. Everything will turn out just fine. Just go with the flow, guys. Thank you guys for tuning in. I love you guys. Thank you for subscribing. If this is your first time listening to the video, please subscribe. I have so many beautiful messages that are meant for you, and I want to make sure that you do get them. Like they say, your vibe attracts your tribe. If you are listening, subscribe, please. Because if this message today is not for you, believe me, there will be one in the future. Or there is one I have already done. I have over 300 and some videos that's waiting for you to listen to. And it's specially made for you. I love you guys. Thanks for tuning in. Blessings to all my kings and queens. Grand Rising all day, every day. Peace.